Okay, I just want to continue with where we left with the slides. So basically, when you have a lean communication channel, that's mean in terms of lowest richness of channel, so need to use automatic processing. But if the channel is a high in richness and also more informations needed, so need to use deliberative or control processing. So we move to barriers to effective communication. As you can see here, there are many barriers: filtering, selective perceptions, emotion, information overload, language, silence, communication apprehensions, lying, and so on. So when we talk about filtering, we talk about we filter some informations to look more favorable. We purposely or deliberately manipulate the information so that it looks favorable by the receivers. So for example, telling boss what they want to hear, so it's also considered as filtering. You filter the information. It's not the real information or it's not the correct information, but you receive the information, you filter, you so you distort the information to look more favorable or unfavorable. So that's what it says, filtering. Selective perception is referring to how receiver, that's mean the audience, will selectively see and hear based on their needs or motivations or interests, experience, and so on. Sometimes they themselves filter or select the one that they want to hear. They do not want to hear the information that against their interests or against their belief. So receivers, that's mean the audience, we who receive the information, will project our interests, our expectations into the communications that we receive, and then we decode the information based on our interests, our preference. So this can distort the informations or distort that can make the informations received to us is kind of not the correct informations. So next is information overload, is referring to informations to our capacity to understand information because of overloads of information that we receive. So sometimes because we have a certain capacity that we could process the information, so if the information keep bombarding, so many information comes in, we cannot process all the information, so we experience information overloads. So see here, information we have to work with actually exceed our processing info capacity. It's not that the information are there that's make the information become overloaded, but because of our limited capacity to process the information, we call it information overloads. Or in other words, we put the information because we don't have the capacity to process all the information, so we have a tendency to select out the information that we want, to select out the information that we do not want, to ignore the information that is not important, to pass over or to forget the information. So we sometimes put aside the information that we do not need or we think is too much until the overload situation is over. So this will result in loss of information and communication become less effective. So as a human being, we have some limitations. So these limitations, if we want to process all the information received, we become information overloads. Information overload is not good because we cannot process all the information that we receive, and then if two overloads, we tend to ignore many of the information. That what it says, and this lead to loss of information and become communications become less effective. In terms of language, the sender sometimes use incorrect terms or words that use the same by receiver as them. For example, those that speak the same language, they say also they understand. Even though they understand the language, but because of the sender use incorrect words and terms, so the understanding also the understanding of the receiver also become distorted. So if communicating in the same language, words can mean different things to different people. For example, certain state, they may understood this word as like this, but certain people come from different state, they may understood differently. So even though they understood the same language, they have different dialect also, that can actually prevent the information to, or the message to be sent as what the sender want it's to be sent. I mean the informations. So Asian context also are the biggest factor that it can influence differences. Like I mentioned, context from different state to other different state, they may understood differently the same term or the same words. And age also may understood, the people come from different age also may understood words differently, even though they use the same words. And next is silence barrier. Another barrier to effective communication is silence. Silence is defined as an absence of information. So research suggests that silence or withholding in communications are common and problematics, because if you are silent, how do you want to convey the information? Of course, you can convey the information through physical appearance, through nonverbal communications, but actually silence can withhold the communications. That means it's one of the barrier to effective communication. Silence is less likely when minority opinions are treated with respect. So in the country where minority are treated with respect, they tend to voice up their opinions. They tend to criticize people, governments, and so on. So silence become less in the culture or in the country where the minority opinions are respected or treated with respect. And also in the group, when the groups, work groups identification is high, people may feel uncomfortable to share some information. So silence become less and less among those who are known each other, identified highly with each other. So communication apprehension is some misunderstanding of the communications. So normally about 5 to 20 in general population suffer from these communication apprehensions. They experience undue tensions and anxiety in oral and written, because they could not understand properly the communications, either oral or written. Find it difficult to talk with others face to face or over the phone. Sometimes when you go to other country, you're not familiar with the language, so you may have problems understanding the context or the words. So to have a communication face to face or over telephones would be problems for those who do not have, who have problems regarding understanding or communication apprehensions. So studies show that those who are oral communications apprehensions, or those who have problem to understand oral communication, or to speak, to have oral communication. For example, some people, they are not really comfortable talking face to face with others or talking in front of the crowd. That's considered communication apprehensions. Not because they cannot speak, but because they are too much anxious, they become blank, they cannot speak. That's considered communication apprehensions. So managers should be aware of the impact of communication apprehensions on job performance. Some people, they are very good at doing their work, but they are not good at explaining or in terms of moral communications. So moral communications is actually a skill that's experienced by everyone. So some people, they have good oral communication skills. Some people, they don't have not really good at oral communicating orally. So those who have a problem communicating orally sometimes experience communication apprehensions, inability to speak like orally. So lying also another barrier is outright misrepresentations of informations. Lying because they distorted the facts, they just create the informations that is not that's right. So it's outright misrepresentations. They are non-verbal and verbal cues. Lying also difficult to be detect, even though there are some cues to detect whether someone is lying or not, but there are no non-verbal or verbal cues that unique to lying. That means quite a very difficult, because if you want to check whether the person is lying through their gaze, through their posing, It is sometimes happen to those who experience shyness, those who are nervous, not because they're lying, but they have other problem, for example, anxious in terms of oral communication. So they may also showing this kind of cues similar to those who are lying. So that's why I said they are not really obvious non-verbal and verbal communication cues when we talk about lying. So, frequency of lying and difficulty in detecting liars. So, it's quite difficult to detect liars also, unless if you've been trained to detect liars, then it will be another story. So, what it says here is it is not generally very difficult to detect people if they are lying. So, this lying is considered a strong barrier to effective communication in the organizations. So how to overcome this problem with the barriers. There are cultural barriers, potential for communication problems can be semantics. So especially if we talk about career, about cultural barriers, culture barrier, different culture, you may understand words or things differently. So caused by semantics, this is one of the cultural barriers caused by semantics. That mean words mean different things to different people. For example, we talk about in English, the English people use the term free market. In Russia, it's not the same. Free market is may been interpreted differently. And also, barrier can be caused by word connotations. Word connotations imply that words are different things in different language. So here, different thing to different people, of different language, of different culture, this one different thing to different language of different culture. See the differences here? For example, in Japan, Japanese people, okay, hi, they use it hi, mean yes, I'm listening, not yes, I am agree, or I agree, not yes, I agree. So it's different understanding word connotations. And culture barriers can be also caused by tone differences. So of course, tones within the same culture, within the same language of the same culture, people may understood tones differently also. So even more if the communication is between cultures or be intercultural. So caused by tone differences in some language, language is formal, in others language is informal. So the tones can be can change depend on the context tones. So the tone change depend on the context. So this is what it says, tone is interpreted differently in different contexts. Another cultural barriers is caused by differences in tolerance for conflicts and method for resolving conflicts. For example, in individualistic culture, it is okay to show disagreement by using overt disagreements or direct conflicts. But in collective culture, people tend to not deal with conflicts implicitly. That means they do not show it directly. They avoid emotionally charged dispute. They do not want to involve in the direct emotional dispute. They want to deal with the conflicts indirectly or implicitly. That's why they tend to address the conflicts in not directly. They not acknowledge the conflicts. I mean, if they did wrong, they didn't come forward and acknowledge that they did wrong. They tend to conceal and then come up with many different excuses. This also can be traced to their cultural background. So here, collectivists acknowledge conflict only implicitly and avoid emotional charge dispute. So they may attribute the conflict to the situations, not to the individual, and they do not require explicit apologies. Like when they did something wrong, they didn't apologize or they didn't say sorry directly to repair the relationship. For individualistic culture, they prefer explicit statement. If they don't like it, they just say don't like it. So there's no obscure, there's no wigs in their showing in terms of disagreement or conflicts and so on. So explicit statement, accepting responsibility for the conflicts and public apologies to restore the relationship. because they are explicit in their statement, so public accept their apologies easily when dealing with the conflicts compared to those coming from collectivistic culture.